use the pain, push through it, and keep going. That's what I keep telling myself. 'Cause yeah, these inflamed fingertips, they're not, it's not fun. Good morning, everybody. This is day two. I'm Alicia Renice, and I've been trying to chronicle my journey learning guitar because I need accountability and I just need somewhere to share my process. And yeah, because I talked about before in the last video how, you know, when you're learning something by yourself, it can feel like, oh, I can fall off, it doesn't matter. But if I have to show up here on a regular basis and like give my report of how I'm improving or not improving or whatever, then I think it'll help me be kind of accountable to myself. And I'm just trying to be in a space where I'm keeping my promises to myself because, yeah, I don't. I'm not disciplined in the least. I have all these dreams, all these things I could be doing, and the discipline is just not there. So I'm trying to build it and work through my fears and like the procrastination, which is really caused by fear of many different things. But yeah, so it's day two. I just got finished practicing. I will say that this morning I was kind of delaying the process, I think. I don't know why. I don't know why. It's like self-sabotage and it's irritating. But either way, you can see my fingertips. If it'll focus, will it focus? Yes. My fingertips are red. From playing guitar strings. And I know all the guitarists out there are looking at me like, but you know, it's a part of the process. It's painful. And it's painful to have to keep practicing with fingertips that hurt. I took a break yesterday and I was like, oh, by the morning, it'll feel fine. It'll be fine. And I'll just pluck away like before. And no, it still hurts. If not worse than last night, which is interesting. It's like more tender now. But either way, I practiced today. And I guess I just want to kind of talk about like pushing through things when it doesn't feel good. You know, no human being on earth likes pain. You know, no one likes pain. No one likes to feel uncomfortable. No one wants to feel like, you know, they're being pushed out of their comfort zone. That's why it's called a comfort zone, because you feel most comfortable in certain situations. But I'm learning that you have to show up even when you don't want to, even when you're tired, even when it hurts, even when you're frustrated. Being patient with yourself because you want to be further along in your journey, like I talked about before, and you're just not. Yeah, so I'm trying to ingrain it in my brain that you have to keep showing up to stuff even when you don't feel like it. And so, like I talked about my fingertips, like how they were hurting and stuff like that. I just gotta push through. I gotta push through, and I gotta apply the pressure. I gotta do the hard things. Like learning anything new is painful. You know what I mean? Like maybe not even physically, but just like frustrating or like mentally draining or like spiritually draining. And that can dissuade us, you know, from continuing what we want to do. That can further delay the inevitable. Some things I feel like you have to go through life because it's life, but stuff with like learning guitar or like picking up a new language or a new hobby or something, there's always that learning process, and I tend to jump off ship on that process. Like in school, things came easy for me, like in high school anyway. Came easy for me. To me it was just kind of it was kind of like commonsensical kind of things. And I don't know if, you know, I'm sure there were challenges for sure, but like I wasn't really challenged in school. And it was fun, and I loved showing up for class. I loved doing trigonometry because it was like puzzles. I loved singing in choir. I loved writing for the newspaper because I loved writing, you know, and the challenges I took on, they were fun for me. But then when it comes to like learning new things that are hard, it seems that I just tend to like check out and be like, okay, I'm done with this. It's frustrating. Let me go back to what I know. Let me go back to what's easy for me. Even with like with my photo projects. So I'm gonna do more photo projects. I'm gonna share the journey with that as well. But having to reach out to people and like schedule interviews and like photo shoots and stuff like that, I hate interacting with people I don't know. It just brings me anxiety. And that can be kind of painful, right? But if I want to get to a point in my career, in my life, where this is what I'm doing full time, like I have to work through the pain and get it done. So I think for anyone out there, the pain of starting, the pain of beginning, the pain of being consistent and keep showing up, like that's going to benefit you in the long run. And I'm trying to tell myself this because, yeah, most times I feel like just giving up. I feel like there's no point. Even with learning guitar, like I talked about before, how I'm not trying to be the next Santana. I'm just trying to learn enough to play. Like I'm trying to learn chords so I can play as I sing along, right? So, because my end goal is not to be a guitarist. It's just to be a singer-songwriter who plays guitar. And so being like, okay, Alicia, well, if that's the focus, if that's the goal, then you can take the pressure off of yourself to be like this amazing guitar player. You know what I mean? Like, you don't have to show tutorials online. Maybe in the future you will, who knows? Like just simple stuff, but that's not my goal. Like my goal is to just become a better musician so I can better communicate the songs that I'm writing, the songs that are in my head. I can put music to it. Most of my music, I use my voice, like I talked about before, like to make chords and things like that. But I wanna be able to like do some stripped down, you know, singer-songwriter-ish things. And so it can be really discouraging because people start learning guitar when they're like 5, 6, 7. Like you hear about the greats, like their uncle had a guitar and they just picked it up and they're just amazing, you know? And it can be really discouraging when you're like, dang, well, I'm in my 20s, you know? And I'm just learning guitar. And like, if I want to get to their level, like how long do I have to be playing, you know? And then you're not really present for the process. You're just kind of frustrated and saying like, oh, I'm not there wherever there is, like I'm not there yet, or I'm not where I want to be yet. And so then you end up not being present, you end up being frustrated, and you don't want to make like your process the enemy, right? Because it's not the enemy, it's making you better. But changing your thinking is like half the battle. And so I'm trying to show up every day and be like, this is fun. I have the privilege to learn guitar. You know what I'm saying? Like I have the privilege of learning, because a lot of people don't. A lot of people don't have money. A lot of people don't have resources to get a guitar. You know, like I saved up and got one that I really liked. You know what I mean? And a lot of people aren't able to do that. And so I need to see it as a privilege for me to learn something, a privilege for me to be able to pursue my dreams and chase my dreams and things like that. So yeah, long rant. But the point is, keep showing up even when it hurts. And you can apply that to anything, life, exercise, marriage. You know what I mean? A lot of people are just kind of like pain averse. And like I said, it makes sense because who wants to be in pain? But some pain, not all pain, is good for you. Some pain is good for you, even in relationships. Some pain is good. It's a great learning tool, right? But we don't want to abuse pain, right? We don't want to take pain as normal or normalize it, because it's not. But I think like traumatic pain, right? So like things like abuse or like molestation or rape or whatever, that is pain that should not happen, right? And it's unfortunate that people have to deal with this, but there are some pains in life that we just have to face head on. And if we don't, we'll be stuck at whatever level in life, you know, we'll be at. So anyway, so that's my thought for today. Use the pain, push through it, and keep going. That's what I keep telling myself. Cause yeah, these inflamed fingertips, it's not fun. The night we met, I knew I needed you so. And if I had the chance, I never let you go. So won't you say you love me? I'll make you so proud of me. We'll make them turn their heads every place we go. So won't you please be my little baby? Say you'll be my darling, be my baby now. Whoa, I'll make you happy, baby. Just wait and see.
for every kiss you give me, I'll give you three. Oh, since the day I saw you, I have been waiting for you. You know I will adore you till eternity, so won't you please be my little baby? Say you'll be my darling, be my baby now. Whoa, oh, 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 oh. Be my little baby. Say you'll be my darling, be my baby now. Whoa, oh, 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 oh.
All right, and that was day two. So, till tomorrow.